Multiple endocrine neoplasia 2, or MEN2. The learning objectives of this presentation are to know the clinical descriptions and classifications of MEN2 syndrome, to know the clinical presentations on history and examination, to understand the pathophysiology and molecular genetics behind MEN2, to appreciate the role of genetic testing and counseling in MEN2, and to appreciate the approach to management and prognosis of MEN2. The outline of the presentation will be the definition of MEN2, its classification and clinical variants, the genetics and pathophysiology of MEN2, history and clinical presentations, physical examination, diagnosis, management, genetic testing, and who should go for genetic testing. The definition of MEN2. Type 2 multiple endocrine neoplasia, or MEN2, is a rare autosomal dominant familial cancer syndrome caused by mutations in the RET proto-oncogene. It is characterized by the presence of medullary thyroid carcinoma, or MTC, pheochromocytoma, either bilateral or unilateral, and hyperplasia or neoplasia of different endocrine tissues within a single patient. MEN2 is subclassified into three clinical syndromes. These are MEN2A, MEN2B, and familial medullary thyroid carcinoma, or FMTC. MEN2A accounts for 75% of MEN2 and is characterized by MTC, pheochromocytoma, and parathyroid hyperplasia. MEN2B has features of MTC and pheochromocytoma, but not hyperparathyroidism. MEN2B syndrome includes mucosal neuromas, typically involving the lips and tongue, and intestinal ganglioneuromas. Patients with MEN2B also typically have development abnormalities, skeletal deformations such as kyphoscoliosis or lordosis, joint laxity, and marfanoid habitus. FMTC is a variant of MEN2A in which there is a strong predisposition to medullary thyroid cancer, but not other clinical manifestations of MEN2A. In both MEN2A and 2B, medullary thyroid carcinoma occurs in almost all patients. There are some variants of MEN2A as listed here. One cohort is associated with cutaneous amyloidosis and the other with Hirschsprung's disease. The MEN syndromes are inherited in an autosomal dominant pattern with very high penetrance. The genetic defect in these disorders involves the RET proto-oncogene on chromosome 10. The RET protein is a receptor tyrosine kinase that appears to transduce growth and differentiation signals in several developing tissues. RET is expressed in the C cells of the thyroid gland, adrenal medulla, neurons, and in other tissues. The germline RET mutations in MEN2 and FMTC result in a gain of function. This is different from almost all other inherited cancer syndromes, which are due to an inherited loss of function mutations that inactivate tumor suppressor proteins. History and presentation of MEN2. On history, you would typically be interested to know if there is a significant family history of multiple cancers. Secondly, related symptoms can manifest from the various cancers and these should be elicited. For MTC, get a history related to the presence of a neck lump or mass, or even diarrhea, as this can be due to prostaglandin release. Ask for the presence of the typical triad of pheochromocytoma, which can include uncontrolled hypertension, diaphoresis, and headaches. Hyperparathyroidism can present with significant hypercalcemia. And more rarely, itchy skin lesions can be an indication of lichen amyloidosis. For the index patient, a young age of presentation and a diagnosis of medullary thyroid hyperplasia or cancer should raise suspicion of RET proto-oncogene mutation. physical examination in MEN2. The physical findings in MEN2 are often subtle and variable. Look for any evidence of uncontrolled blood pressure or tachycardia, as this can be present if there's a pheochromocytoma. Examine the neck carefully for any thyroid masses or cervical lymph adenopathy. Some thyroid neoplasias can be small and easily missed on physical examination. Look generally for any typical features associated with MEN2, such as the marfanoid habitus, neuromas, and skin lesions of amyloidosis. As history and examination are often subtle, specific tests directed at the known associated neoplasias are important. Nearly all patients with MEN have medullary thyroid carcinoma very early on. Therefore, an ultrasound scan of the thyroid followed by a fine needle aspiration and cytology examination is necessary if there's a suspicion of thyroid nodules. Serum calcitonin levels are raised, and sometimes this can aid us in the diagnosis of MTC. For pheochromocytomas, clinical symptoms are often telling, and elevated plasma or urinary measurements of metanephrines and catecholamines are diagnostic. In hyperparathyroidism, biochemical findings of hypercalcemia and high parathyroid hormone levels are diagnostic. Management of MEN2. Management of the tumors are essentially surgical resection. Medullary thyroid carcinoma or MTC can be cured only by complete resection of the tumor and any local or regional metastases. In MEN2, there is a role in prophylactic thyroidectomy. The hallmark of MEN2 is multicentric hyperplasia of the thyroid parafollicular C cells, and the penetrance is nearly 100%. So, a very high proportion of MEN2 patients are destined to develop clinically apparent MTC, and it can occur in young children. Therefore, an important issue here is the optimal timing of prophylactic thyroidectomy in children screen positive for the RET mutation. Often the type of RET mutation can assist in predicting the risk of carcinoma. Patients with MTC should be evaluated for possible pheochromocytoma and hyperparathyroidism before thyroidectomy. If a pheochromocytoma is found, it should be removed first. Genetic testing in MEN2. In contrast to MEN1, in which the long-term benefit of early diagnosis by genetic screening is not well established, early diagnosis of MEN2 is essential, because medullary thyroid carcinoma is a life-threatening disease that can be cured or prevented by early thyroidectomy. In an MEN2 family, a sample from one subject already known to be affected should be tested in order to determine the specific RET mutation for that family. When a germline RET mutation is found, all subjects of unknown status should then be genotyped. The RET genotyping requires only a small blood sample and can be easily performed at birth or soon thereafter. Identification of the specific mutation can assist in predicting particular phenotypes of the patient. This guides clinicians in surveillance and management of the disease. Who should go for genetic screening in MEN2? This table summarizes the suggested groups of patients who will benefit. These include clinically proven MEN2 syndrome patients, MTC or pheochromocytoma and a family member with similar history of such tumors, and apparently sporadic MEN2 related tumor in a patient who is younger than 35 years of age, who have multicentric tumors in one organ or two different organs, first and second degree relatives of MEN2 patients, and lastly, all patients with sporadic medullary thyroid carcinoma. In summary, MEN2 is subclassified into three syndromes, MEN2A, familial medullary thyroid carcinoma, and MEN2B. The defect is in a genetic germline mutation in the RET proto-oncogene. The hallmark of MEN2 is hyperplasia of the parafollicular C cells of the thyroid gland and penetrance is 100%. Genetic screening of at-risk individuals is beneficial. And finally, there is a role in prophylactic thyroidectomy in high-risk individuals with MEN2.